Sequence Z, anything but with Kumar de Silva. I'm at the beautiful terrace of the Colombo City Hotel at Canal Row, opposite the World Trade Center. The Dutch hospital just beside me. It's a beautiful place here, this open air terrace to the sky. My guest is waiting to have coffee with me. I'm so honored, Nayana Karunaratne. Now, Nayana, we talk about SLAHAB, your baby, your big baby, your 21 years old. What made you form SLAHAB?
Actually, the idea of getting foreign people and getting ourselves trained was something that I started. My husband, and we had also seen when you go abroad how organized they are. So this gentleman, Juno Incarnation, was brought. He was the Asia Zone president and also Philippines. So twice or thrice he came and we were very successful. And he noticed that we are very united. He noticed that we are compared to all the other industries. We are from Vasanta to Ramsi to all of us are close together. So any seminar had 100, 200 people. Then he said, after about third visit, he said, why don't you form an association? Because you can do much more.
So what does SLAHAB do?
So we started with education because that was missing very badly. I think exposure and education is what we gave. And now of course our requirements have changed. We are going into more basic education and we are trying to bring in salon registrations and salon standards.
How big is your membership? How strong is your membership?
We have a 12,000 database. I don't think everybody is active. About 8,000 are active.
Where are they?
All over the country. From Jaffna to Point Pedro, everywhere.
So hairdressing is no longer the prerogative of Colombo-based hairdressers?
No, definitely not. No. It's spread out a lot. But the levels are there, different levels. We are apparently having 43,000 salons, including barbershops in this country.
So do the barbershops come into this?
They don't come to us much because they are still scared and shy. Okay. They are not organized, but they are definitely part of us. Definitely part of us.
Can one earn well being a hairdresser?
Very well. Very well. It's because...
out of Colombo, say, Candy, Goldmata.
Everywhere. Because you have to understand, it's a job that doesn't require 9-to-5 commitment. It's a job that you can do a few days. And it's a job that spreads happiness.
And work out of home also.
Work from home.
Push, yes.
And you can have your family do it as a part-time job, do certain days, and you make much more money than someone who would be going regularly to an office with a mediocre job. And it's not exposed, but they make a lot of money.
You spoke of standards. So how do you regulate standards? I mean, 43,000 salons. All over Sri Lanka?
Actually, this is the biggest task at the moment and the worry also. As a first step, I'm very proud to say we have worked with the government and we have got the SLSI standards done and approved. We worked 2 years, we were invited by the government and I was very much a part of the team. So it was sorted out, done and approved. Now, SLSI doesn't implement. Now, we have to start implementing that same. The salon standards. Basically,
how do you plan to do this? Are they willing to learn? Do they want to elevate their standards and the offerings?
See, more than anything, first thing is to grade them, right? So it's like hotels, you have ABC grades.
But then I won't like to be called a secret salon.
We are not going to grade you and say you are C grade and stick to C grade.
Okay.
We are only coming and saying what have you got.
Your blow dry has gone for a 6.
No? What have you got? What would you do? So what you know do, and to do, if you say for instance, if you only know to do threading and waxing, do that and have your setup accordingly. Practice the health and hygiene standards required for that and do this. Don't go to color the hair because you are not qualified. You are qualified to do the threading and waxing only. And if you want to upgrade yourself, get your qualification and next year, we will include that in it.
So where do we get the qualification? Where
so qualifications are available all over. Now the government is doing NBQ, private companies academies are doing, you can go abroad, qualifications are available. The problem is that people don't still understand the standards.
That's a tough job.
Tough job because we are handling people. We are not handling lifeless equipment. We are handling people. So the standards, especially health, hygiene and safety, standards have to be very high.
So are they willing to learn?
Everyone will be willing to learn. Everyone will be willing to learn if they are not. I'll give you an example. We have a qualification called IHB, and we do certificate level, which is the lowest for a salon, like an assistant. Now, I did exams in Amravati. Amravati in India is 1.5 hours by flight and 3.5 hours by car. And it was a very remote place. There were 9 girls who sat for the exam. You know, everyone who dropped the comb, washed the comb in Amravati.
What?
Everyone who dropped it. They all used towels, fresh towels. And every time, they had only one shampoo unit. Every time somebody washed the hair, they wiped. There was a piece of towel, wiped it and left it. So this is teaching. This is teaching. So the 9 children who learn to pick and wash the comb, you think they'll ever not wash the comb? They will. They were taught the first time. They were taught to use a clean towel. In fact, they said, we learned, studied a lot, ma'am, you didn't ask us questions. I said, there are nothing to ask. I was observing. This is practical. I was observing the combs being washed. I saw the sink being wiped and cleaned. And I said, you did a head massage with oil. And you blow dried the hair, shining and smooth. That means you were smart to get rid of the oil. Your shampoo was good. You need to select the correct shampoo and the conditioner. That's hairdressing. That's education. So it can be done.
So do our hairdressers help us?
If they are taught correctly, yes, they will have it. Why not? Anyone who comes to the industry are the ones who love it. And they want to do it properly.
Are the seniors in the industry willing to impart their knowledge and help these people out there?
Some do, some don't.
Yeah,
see, Kumar, I have read this somewhere. I firmly believe there are 3 kinds of teachers. You must have heard this.
Say it, please.
Teachers who can teach and who want to teach. They are the good ones. Teachers who want to teach, they can't teach. Now, if you take my Kanchana, she's like that. They want to, but they don't know to teach. People don't. Then the teachers who can teach and who don't want to teach. So there are
how many of that third category, those who can teach and do not want to teach?
There are many, lot and lot and lot in the hairdressing industry. You know why? Not because they are selfish. They are very, they are not confident. They think if I teach, I'll lose business. It doesn't happen
that
like
insecurity.
That. So insecure. They are very insecure. They are scared. So they think, why should I learn? I mean, very recently they requested a teacher's training program for about, I think we had 57 teachers. They requested me to come. So we did a big seminar at the Garadari. During the seminar, I was told that people at the back are discussing, it's good to learn all these things, don't go and teach everything to the students, okay? Not necessary to teach everything. So I would say it's insecurity and stupid, foolishness. It never works like that.
So can this industry go forward?
It is going forward. It is going forward. Only thing is, it is going forward, you can't stop it. But it's a little haywire.
My last question, compared to the Southeast Asian region where we are located, where does the Sri Lankan hair and beauty industry rank?
We are only behind Japan and Korea. We are not even less than Singapore. We are on par with Hong Kong, Singapore, Malaysia, all those countries.
You see that India
is India 100%. I'm the Asia zone president for the World Federation. So I know even India is way behind. See, India are 1.1 billion people. They have some super duper hairdressers, that's no question about it. But such a handful compared to the size. I'm talking ratio. So considering that, we are far ahead.
So on that very positive note, Nayana, thank you very much for being my guest. It was extremely interesting talking to you.
Thank you.
This has been Anything But with Kumar de Silva, sponsored by LICC Jeans, the beautiful terrace of the Colombo City Hotel in Canal Rocal Mobile. We catch you again somewhere soon in our space.